Hi everyone! When you're growing your own food, like many of us are here, it's always nice to have a few garden tips you can just pull out of your back pocket and make life in the garden that much simpler. Gary over at The Rusted Garden and I are going to be sharing five of our favorite garden tips with you today and also announcing the Show What You Grow Instagram contest winners. If you follow us both on Instagram, you'll know that Gary and I teamed up for a worldwide Instagram contest where we asked our followers to post a 60-second video showing what they grow in their garden along with sharing a garden tip. Thank you to everyone who entered. We had so many wonderful videos to choose from. It was really hard, but we did pick three winners, and the winners have received a free copy of my ebook, Growing Warm Weather Vegetables Made Easy, and we're featuring their videos today where they're gonna share their garden and garden tip with us. Now Gary's in Maryland in Zone 7 on the East Coast, and I'm in Southern California in Zone 9B on the West Coast. So when you subscribe to both of our channels, you really get a nice mix of gardening zones, which can really help you in your garden as well. Here's Gary with the first garden tip.
One of my favorite tips for gardeners, and when you don't know it, you don't know it, and when somebody explains it to you, you're like, hey, that makes perfect sense. Anytime that you're cutting your loose leaf lettuces or greens, instead of pulling out the whole plant, cut it down at root level just like this. In 10 to 14 days, you're going to have regrowth, and you're going to get at least two, maybe three harvests out of your loose leaf lettuces. This was cut back about 10 days ago, and you can see all the new growth that's coming out of here. And even if it doesn't get to a full head, you'll be able to pick off the leaves and you're going to have more lettuces for your garden salads. And I want to introduce Tracy Monster, who I feel like I got to know you a little bit in that 1 minute video. She does some great things with the community garden. She gives the food away and she's going to give you a great tip on what you can do with food scraps.
Hi everybody, my name is Tracy, also known as Tracy Monster on social media, and I am here today at my community garden that I started back in April of 2016, and I am in sunny Southern California in Zone 9B. I absolutely love to grow and donate all of our fruits and vegetables that we grow here at the community garden to help serve those that are in need. We've used redwood for our raised beds. And in our raised beds, we are getting ready to harvest some jalapeno peppers. We have a gorgeous head of butterhead lettuce, a gorgeous looking zucchini, some amazing looking tomatoes, some parsley, and some bell peppers to name a few. One of my tips is to bring your kitchen scraps from home and re-nourish the soil by digging a hole and putting your scrap into the dirt.
Tracy, you did a really good job with your video, as did the contestants that are showcased in our series today. I also wanted to point out again that I'm on the East Coast, Kim is on the West Coast, and her tip has to do with planting garlic where you don't get a cold season. Here in Maryland Zone 7, I put my garlic in now. It overwinters, the ground freezes, and it's ready to go in the spring. Her tip's going to show you what do you do if you want to grow garlic in a place that doesn't get a winter.
Well, my tip is about growing garlic. Now, garlic loves the cold weather, and here in Southern California, it gets pretty warm in the winter time. So what I like to do to help my garlic out before I plant it is just put it in the refrigerator for a couple of weeks, just the whole heads of garlic, stick them in the fridge before you plant them, just to kind of simulate the cold weather and to get them going. Then I really like to plant them in containers. Now, I just planted some here last week in this little mini raised bed. It hasn't come up yet. But once I take them out of the refrigerator, I just plant them blunt side down. It has nice loose soil, so it's going to grow really nicely for you over the winter time. And then in about 6 months, they'll be ready to harvest. Our next winning video comes from Des from Retro Flowers here on YouTube. She has an awesome gardening channel, so make sure you head over to check her out. Here's Des to show us what she's growing in her garden.
Hey, it's Des of Retro Flowers, and I'm from Texas Zone 9A. Here's some cilantro and some buttercrunch lettuce, mint oregano and prickly pear cactus, lemongrass between two lemon trees I'm trying to rehabilitate, as well as lemon drop pepper plant and rosemary. A few pepper plants that might give me some more peppers before it gets cold. Snow peas, kale, pecan tree and some aloe. What I'm most proud about are my eggplants that actually came back from last year. They overwintered. And my beautiful basil. I have just the largest basil plants ever. I love them. I've got some stuff growing inside. My favorite gardening tip was actually from Gary Pilarchik, and that's to use the neem oil that's cold-pressed with the azadirachtin in it.
We are fully rolling into the fall here in Maryland Zone 7 on the East Coast, and that's the time that I start saving bean seeds. I highly recommend you do it. It's really easy, and you'll save yourself some money, and you can collect hundreds of seeds that you can actually trade with people, too, if you want. My tip is let the green bean or the red bean or any kind of bean fully mature on the vine. Do not pick this, let it dry in the house, because you're not going to get a fully mature bean inside. You can see that it's starting to plump, but you want this to grow until it starts looking just like this. And that'll come about 2 or 3 weeks after full maturity. The outside will dry, you just crack it open just like this, you know, take it off the vine, and you'll get plenty of beans that you can use for production next year in your garden, or you can save them for a food source. Once you harvest all the dried pods off the vines, put them into a Ziploc bag. If you're going to eat them or use them for soups or something like that, I recommend you freeze the Ziploc bag with the beans in it for about a week. That will kill out any insects. If you're going to use them for food production, put a small pinch of insect dust in there. Any variety or any kind that you want will work perfectly fine. You just want to kill off the insects or any kind of beetle larva. If you've ever seen Mexican jumping beans hop, that's because there's beetle larva inside the beans themselves. Once they're in the Ziploc bag, put them into a brown bag, label them. This will keep the light off of them. The beans will store in here for a good 2 to 3 years, and you can use them in your garden or trade with friends.
My next garden tip involves growing cilantro. Now, cilantro loves the cool weather, so wintertime is really an ideal time to grow out here in Southern California, where the weather is a little bit cooler, but it can take about 2 weeks to germinate, and that can get frustrating waiting so long. So what I like to do is take my rolling pin, I have my seeds, they have really hard little seed pods. I like to just crush up my seed pods with the rolling pin, that way it opens them up and helps them germinate quicker. Now I have some I planted here from seed on my little wallflower saddle planter, and they actually germinated in about half the time by using this little garden tip. So hopefully that'll help you grow some more cilantro, especially if you live in a warm winter climate. Our last contest winner is House of Hurley's over on Instagram, so make sure you head over to check out her profile, and here she is to show us her garden and give us her garden tip.
Hey guys, it's Cece Hurley over at House of Hurley's. I just came out to the garden today. It just stopped raining, which is super exciting because we don't get much rain here. We're in Southern California in Orange County, gardening zone 9B. One of my biggest words of advice would be, if something doesn't work one season, just keep trying. I mean, I've had lots of failures, but get connected in the garden community on social media like Instagram or YouTube. There's so much advice out there, and the right way to grow something, you can always learn something new. And I think that's the whole point of gardening. It's just a big community of gardeners sharing their words of wisdom with each other and helping each other out. One of the main reasons why I garden is because I think it's super important to show your kids where food comes from, and it's super fun. It's nothing's more exciting than coming in your backyard, picking your own fruits and vegetables, and cooking them up for dinner. The girls absolutely love it, and so do we. So grow your own food. Thanks for watching.
Iron phosphate is the most effective way to kill snails and slugs in your garden. It's for organic use. It's safe against other wildlife. I have a 14-pound dog who's been around this product for 5 years. The iron phosphate's in these tiny little pellets. They're baited. They attract the snails and slugs. You don't leave massive piles. You just lightly sprinkle it around. The slugs and snails will go to it, they eat it, it shuts down their digestive system, and in a couple of days they die. This is my radish bed, and in here I actually missed putting out my iron phosphate because I was on vacation and it's the fall, and I thought, maybe they're not going to be around. But they've been chewing down my radishes. This application of iron phosphate will kill out the slugs, my radishes will develop, and I'll have no issues. This is really a game changer if you have trouble with your greens getting chewed down by snails and slugs. Thank you so much for watching Show What You Grow. This is a new series and it's going to continue through 2017. If you have any feedback, certainly please leave us some comments. And it's also an Instagram contest, and you can find out the rules in the description to this video of how you can send in videos to us and maybe end up on the series. And basically, you got to follow Kim and I on Instagram. I want to thank the people who send in videos. I think it's very, very brave of you. And I want to encourage everybody to go out into their garden, shoot some videos for family and friends, and share them on YouTube channel or on Facebook, and really teach people from around the globe how to have better gardens through your experience. Thank you. Welcome to Show What You Grow, or more importantly.
Actually put my heads of garlic in the refrigerator for a couple of months.
This is going to be an ongoing series, so if you have any feedback for us, please also an Instagram contest. So if you want to get your video on the series.
It can be a little bit challenging to grow. Cut.
If you want to get your video on the series, check out the description in the video and it will tell you how to...